I have to admit that in my line of work, club promoter, it is a rare night indeed where ecstasy is hard to come by. But so it was on a stiflingly hot August night last year, that despite our best efforts, we were informed in no uncertain terms that the town was completely dry in this respect, but, unusually, was boasting something of a surplus of LSD and 2CB. We had been looking forward to the night for a long while, what with it being the opening of an ex-colleague's club, and we were not going to let a lack of ecstasy spoil our night, and hence bought a sheet of acid, 100 trips, and 22 CBs between five of us. In my experience, clubbing on 2CB can go one of two ways. Either I stand at the back of the dance floor with a manic glare on my face, having a great time but unable to interact fully, or I hit the dance floor and stay there until I have to be physically removed. On this occasion, the drug chose the latter, and by 2 a.m. I had deposited my share of the 2CBs. The setting was, as always, an important factor in the drug's potency and pleasure-giving potential, and the DJ, the light show and the warm and friendly crowd played no small role in the success of the trip up to this point. 2CB is a very clinical drug, especially visually, with objects sharply defined in vision and mind, and although some people I have talked to find the restrained rushes in the sternum unpleasant, I find that a beer or two works wonders, though make sure to keep up your liquid intake, as I find 2CB dehydrates me considerably in the hot weather. By the time the five of us got back to the house, we were visibly high, but were missing the atmosphere of the club. We set up the decks and started playing some new school breaks, a jazzed up, breakbeat successor to drum and bass, which really hit the spot, although appearing to my addled mind as less a coherent flow of music than a fascinating collection of liquid sounds. About 20 minutes or so after we got back, we did two of the California Sunshines, which took away some of the hard edge of the 2CB and gave way to fluffy pinks and yellows. The room took on a very ethereal edge, and I began to feel empathy and warmth I had not felt since my first few ecstasy tablets, nearly 8 years before. At this point, it is perhaps best to explain that my friends and I have taken a lot of drugs in each other's company, and as a consequence, we know almost precisely how another will react in any given situation, and how to deal with that moment. If you lack that connection with your particular partners in crime, think long and hard about whether you want to take the same course we took next. Having taken 4 2CBs and 2 trips, we decided each to do 3 more trips in one go, which I was initially wary of, but at this point of the evening all I was fit to do was more acid, so I duly cut the acid from the sheet and handed it around. I have never taken drugs accidentally before, but what happened next ensured I never will again. Having forgotten that I had taken the first 3 hits of acid, I promptly dropped another 3 hits, bringing my total to 8 for the evening and 6 in the last 5 minutes. These trips were very strong, but fortunately very clean, otherwise I think I may well have gone mad. Well, all I can say is that I have never been so high. My friends would turn to me to say something and I would see them in reverse, a highly freaky scenario which I have no wish to repeat. I had the power to move objects round the room, and lift objects as heavy as televisions, simply with a wave of my hand. It also started snowing rather heavily in the room. This did not seem at all strange, and my only wonder was that my friends had not noticed it. I have to say that my friends were marvelous throughout, and had it not been for them constantly humoring me, and keeping a rein on my more lunatic ambitions, the trip would have descended deeply into chaos. The trip from this point on was not all sweetness and light, especially the following afternoon when the trip began to peter out and sleep proved hard to come by, and I would not recommend it to anyone who is at anything other than the right time and place for the experience. I was, and several months later the experience is still prominent in my psyche. I must confess that contrary to almost all my other drug experiences, this one also threw up more questions than answers, some of which I am working on to this day.